Now this is something in North Carolina you get a lot. What we have here is what is known as a briar patch. So we're gonna have to find our way around. If you see here, these nice, wonderful, green vines everywhere have nice, wonderful, quarter inch, half inch thick thorns. Always so much fun. Let's see if we can find our way. Okay, we're about 20 feet, give or take, from the cache. I'm switching to radar mode and see if we can find this puppy. If we're lucky, we'll find it straightforward. If not, we'll look for a hint. Let's see what we can get. Okay, so according to Geocaching Navigator, we're only about 13 feet from the cache. Let's see if we can find it. We are literally in the middle of a briar patch. There are thorns everywhere with razor sharp vines and thorns. These are really, really a pain in North Carolina to geocache. You see them everywhere. Ah, there it is. Ah, speaking of thorns, I got one wrapped around my leg. That's always good. Here it is. It's a small green ammo box. Geocaching on it. Let's open it up and see what's inside. Standard logbook. Ooh, we got all sorts of stuff in here. Little goodies. I don't see any geocoins or travel bugs, but hey, that happens. Lots of little tidbits and toys to go. So this is how you find caches using Geocache Navigator. Really easy to do, quick to find, and that radar is just dead on when it comes to finding caches. Boy, this cache was really a lot of a challenge and fun. We had that wonderful briar bush to go through. Today just seems to be the day for pokey, different types of pokey vegetation when geocaching. It happens. Now what I'm going to do is get back on Geocaching Navigator, log that we found this cache, move on to the next one. This is part of our film crew walking a trail. Actually found the trail after we bushwhacked all the way to the cache. She has helped guiding us back to our car. Her legs are bleeding, her arms are bleeding. Geocaching can be so much fun. Next cache site using Geocache Navigator. Now we went from map mode to detail, so I'm reading about it right now. We're looking for a regular sized geocache, so it could be a lock and lock box, it could be an ammo box. Right now we don't know. It's a difficulty of 2, terrain of 1.5, should be pretty easy to look upon. Okay. We're within about 8 to 10 feet of the cache right now. I'm going to switch from compass mode over to radar. Radar is a way of finding the cache really quickly, very simple. You have an arrow, you have a dot that shows where the cache is. Make the arrow touch the dot. All there is to it. Let's go find it. Okay. Our radar says we're dead on ground zero. Ground zero means you're at the spot where the coordinates meet up to 0, 0. Let's see if we can actually find the cache. It's called Big Old Log. We found this big concrete tube here. Inside is a log. I got a pretty good feeling this is where it's at. Let's see if we can find it. Notice more thorns, more briar patch stuff. Always be careful. When you go to reach up a log, always have a stick or something to go through. Now we shook this up. I'm pretty sure there's nothing in there. Let's take a look. Always be careful of spiders, another big thing to be careful. Now what this is a special kind of geocache. We got a green tube. Oh, cool. This is the log. How cool is that? Big orange piece of paper, construction paper. This was back first find back in August 8th of 08. We're gonna sign the log right now. A couple little trinkets and a pen. I'm gonna sign this. We're gonna put everything back, and I'm gonna put some goodies in here just in case. Hey, folks, this is what we like to do when we go geocaching. Nobody says you have to, but one of the rules when you geocache is if you take something out of a cache, replace it with something else of equal or better value. This is my swag bag. It's full of all sorts of different goodies and stuff that I've either found or bought at the dollar store. Things that you can trade and swap with. We've already taken a couple items out of this cache. I'm going to replace it with one of my signature first aid kits. One of the other things that I carry around is my travel bug and geocoin bag. In here are different one travelers that we put into from one cache to another. So what I'm going to do now is take this and a couple other items, fill up the cache, and put a couple travel bugs in there too so they get on their way. And these are things you should know. Hey folks, HeadHardHat here. Little quick reminder for you when it comes to geocaching. One of the main themes of this game sport or obsession is a thing called CITO. In other words, cash in and trash out. That means every time you go from your car to a geocache, as a geocacher, you should be going along the trails and picking up garbage. Now, one of the cool things that I found that you can put into a geocache is a 35 millimeter container. Instead of a logbook on it, I usually put a little sticker on the outside saying CITO. When you open it up, there's one of those little grocery plastic bags in there. That way, when a person finds one of these 35 millimeter containers in a cache, they can pick up trash, take it right out to their car and throw it out. Then they can go back and refill the 35 millimeter with another plastic bag and then put it in the next cache you find. Now, a little helpful hint from the HeadHardHat to you. Well, we hope you enjoyed this episode of GeoSnippits. I know we had a lot of fun. We laughed. We got poked by pointy vegetation. It's cold here. We're having a cold snap in North Carolina where it's only 35 degrees instead of 60 as usual. I can't feel my fingers anymore. All part of the fun about geocaching. We hope you enjoyed this episode and you come back real soon for even more interesting information and tidbits about geocaching. This HeadHardHat saying, we hope to see you out on the trails real soon. Bye-bye, folks.